And I'm going to pose it a little bit differently, because I think, correct me if I'm wrong, Burglar, the poll was like, which of these should get banned? Was there a neither or both column? I don't know. I didn't follow it as closely as I should have. But we'll just start with that. Do you think, without even drilling down to these specific cards, do you think that Modern needs a banning?
If I got to wait and see for GP Detroit, I would, to try to just see what the metagame shakes out to be. I'm going to skip that tournament, in fact, but so I'm not worried about Modern too much right now. I think the Eldrazi decks are too good, but it's an interesting question whether or not you want a metagame where they have to keep Eldrazi in mind to be able to be competitive,
yeah.
If that's something you want, or you just want to ban a piece of Eldrazi to make it worse and we go back to happy days or whatever. But I think Eldrazi is beatable, but I do think it has to warp your deck. You need to be playing things like Ensnaring Bridges, and you know, there's been a million different articles written about
how do you beat
this Eldrazi menace.
Sure.
And a lot of the suggestions are either the same or they say, I don't know how we beat the deck. So that is a bad sign that it is too powerful. And also, mirrors are kind of horrible. I had to play a mirror at the Pro Tour, and it was not enjoyable for either side of the party, I don't think.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, did you curve out? Did I curve out? What's happening? I do think something should be banned. The question is, should it be banned right away, or do we let this deck be here for a little while?
Yeah.
I do think within the next year, there should be a piece banned.
Do you think the answer is unbanning something else, or taking a piece away from this deck?
I think you need to unban a lot to give a lot of different options to be able to beat this deck. Because if you just unban like one random card, I don't think that's going to help. Like Ancestral Visions isn't going to stop it.
Oh, it's too slow.
Bloodbraid Elf isn't going to make Jund now all of a sudden just better than this deck. Bloodbraid Elf's a 3/2
right.
In a field of 7/7s.
Yeah, it's outclassed.
Right?
It's totally
not gonna work.
Outclassed.
So I think you need to unban a lot of different pieces and see where the format shakes out.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is a lot of the pieces on the ban list are just completely degenerate. Like, there are things like Rite of Flame, right?
Yeah.
Where
you
just
that,
like,
that you, that we
combo,
know,
combo, 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 kill
yeah,
you, right?
You
like, that's not where we want to go with the deck.
Right, right.
And so I don't know what one piece would really help. I know you were mentioning maybe Jace last week.
Yeah.
I think the biggest problem for Jace to be unbanned is just the price tag, honestly. I think WotC's afraid to unban like a $200 card, but I don't know.
Hey, man, Modern Masters 3. Modern Masters 2017.
That would be a good time to do it.
Yeah. Hey, it could be an Eternal Masters. You think they have Jace the Mind Sculptor in Eternal Masters?
I think they could. I think the focus was on really old cards, though, is what they maybe hinted at.
It was,
at.
But it could be a good opportunity to get some more Jaces out there.
Yeah, no, I think Jace is a totally reasonable card. I mean, they reprinted in Vintage Masters for Magic Online.
Oh, yeah, and it was fine there.
It was totally awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, it was completely busted in draft, obviously, but it was still really sweet.
There's nothing you do about that. You open it.
I mean,
draft.
When you just open up Jace and have a great time.
Yeah, Yahtzee.
It's just like, I mean, you also could open up Black Lotus. So, I mean,
yeah,
anything is possible.
That's true.
Right?
What do you? Okay, make a prediction, Neil. Jace the Mind Sculptor in Eternal Masters or not?
I'm gonna say not in Eternal Masters.
Burglar, where are you at on this? Burglar says he thinks it's in there.
All
you know
right,
what?
Well, I was hoping, because that way, you know, we get to see who's right.
Yeah, I, either way, I was going to say yes. I don't know why I hadn't thought about it till now, but I think there's a good chance that Jace the Mind Sculptor is in Eternal Masters. So we'll
possible.
See. Yeah. I'd love to see it. So come on, WotC, give us some Jace. Okay, so if we're going to ban something, Temple, or both?
I think Temple. And here are my reasonings.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, why?
One eye goes in Tron. And I think it was a really nice piece in Tron to go search for and then be able to go get your big stupid spells, right? That's sort of a key pivotal piece. You play the one eye, Expedition Map goes finds it. I hate Tron with a passion, but I know people love it, and it's a totally reasonable thing to have in a turn 3/4 format that Modern is. Additionally, if you have four eyes versus four temples, eye is going to lead to busted mimic starts, but it's not going to necessarily lead to ramping out multiple things. Like if I go Eye of Ugin, play a Mimic, mm-hmm. I can't play a Thought-Not Seer the next turn, because what am I going to do? Play another Eye of Ugin? That's not going to create that much mana. Whereas if I do have a double Temple draw, I can go turn one Mimic, turn two Thought-Not Seer.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Off two Temples. Mm-hmm. The only reason you could do that was because of the interaction of the two, so that you often could play Thought-Not Seer on turn two in Modern, because you can have a Temple or Eye Temple, mm-hmm. right? Which obviously is way easier and probably too good.
Right.
But I think just the like triple Mimic draws didn't come up enough that I'm that concerned about Eye of Ugin. Plus, the deck's going to be so much worse with only four eyes. Like, you're going to have some busted starts, but it's not... Outside of the Mimics, it's not that common that you're going to be able to play multiple Eldrazi in a turn because of the cost reduction without Temple. Like, at the Pro Tour, I played, you know, Eye into a Mimic, turn two, play a Temple, play double Mattery Shaper off the Temple.
Yeah.
But I still can't do that off just any colorless land. Even if I have Eye, I just play one. And so most of the time, the cards are going to be pretty functional or pretty much the same. Now, that being said, Eye lets you get to the point of the game where you've stabilized and you start tutoring, but I think that's totally reasonable because that costs like 7 mana or something,
right?
And your deck's doing fairer things now otherwise, so it prevents the super busted draws. Well, it doesn't prevent the most busted draws, but it prevents the majority of the busted draws, if that makes sense.
That makes complete sense. Like, and you think they should do that eventually?
Yeah, I think the Eldrazi deck's too good for Modern.
Awesome. I mean, I'm hopeful that the metagame can develop and shift and find a way out. Obviously, without Pillage to blow up these eyes and temples, it's a real challenge. But hey, if it was easy, if they just reprinted Pillage, it wouldn't be as fun. So we got to find our non-Pillage.
Pillage would also get rid of the Ensnaring Bridges that are the tech against Eldrazi. So then you can attack with your Jackal Pups.
Yeah, it'd be pretty amazing because you're taking care of the Eldrazi and you're taking care of all the people who are toting answers to the Eldrazi. It would probably break the format wide open. We'd have like a month of Pillage before they had to do an emergency banning. And they're ahead of the game. They don't want to put it in Modern. I respect that. Good call, Wizards of the Coast. Do you have the poll results, Russ? Couldn't find it on Twitter. Oh, man. I thought Avi was going to leave that up. No worries. Well, we did run a poll, and I'd love to tell you what the results were. I don't have them at my fingertips, unfortunately. But, I hope a banning isn't in our future. I'm so much more a fan in Modern of unbanning versus banning. That I hope that if a solution's needed, and I'm still not convinced the solution's needed, of course, you're much more of an authority on this than I am. I hope that the route they take is unbanning. I will say this as a testament to the power of the Eldrazi. Did you play in any of the Modern Gauntlet stuff that was on Moto?
No, because I had just played so much Modern leading up to Pro Tour that I felt like I had already done that.
Well, Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso loved the whole idea of the gauntlet. So he...
Yeah, it was a great idea.
Yeah, he played the gauntlet and immediately got dealt Eldrazi, the CFB version of Eldrazi, and like just crushed everybody. And it's hilarious because he was literally like looking at the cards, having to like take a closer look. What does this card do? What does this card do? What does this card do? Okay. And then just, you know, 3-0s. And he, afterwards, he was telling me, like, Mosh, it is insane. It's like, I don't even know what the cards do. I don't know what my opponent's cards do. It doesn't matter. You just destroy them. And he's like, he was talking about it afterwards, and he played in the gauntlet multiple times. So he got, you know, apparently the Mardu deck is not great. But sorry, Paul. Reitzel.
I lost to Mardu at the Pro Tour.
Oh, wow. I've heard not that great. But what Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso was saying is like, he was playing Eldrazi clearly suboptimally. Clearly, like, he didn't know how to play the deck. He wasn't super familiar with all the cards, and his lines of play weren't correct because, you know, isn't playing the format, doesn't play enough Magic, and he was still rolling people. So he definitely came away from that experience with the gauntlet saying that it's overpowered in the metagame right now, way too powerful.
Yep, very busted.
Yeah, hilariously enough, and it takes a lot for this. Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso actually tweeted out to Wizards, I think it was at Lee Sharp, please don't get rid of the gauntlet, keep it for another week, keep it for longer, because it actually got him to play Magic Online. Like, normally he'll draft here and there, but he was so excited about the gauntlet that A, he played multiple times, and B, was actually motivated enough to get on Twitter and tweet, you know, WotC, please keep the gauntlet. And that's when we found out exactly how much power Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso has, because you will notice now there's champions drafts. Sorry, John.